Good morning. Here is today's word of blessings for you. Ephesians 3:14 21. For this reason I kneel before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth derives its name. I pray that out of his glorious riches he may strengthen you with power through his Spirit in your inner being. Oh, that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith. And I pray that you, being rooted and established in love, may have power, together with all the Lord's holy people, to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ, and to know this love that surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled to the measure of all the fullness of God. Now to him who is able to do immeasurably more than all we ask or imagine, according to his power that is at work within us, to him be glory in the Church and in Christ Jesus throughout all generations, for ever and ever. Amen. Today's title is How Wide and Long and High and Deep. For ordinary people, life seems fairly routine. Sometimes it feels even so tedious. It seems that we repeat the routine of the same things almost every day. We eat. We work. We sleep. There are only a few new things in between. What do you think? Did you even feel the same way about your own life? I think we all do feel so once in a while. But Christian life certainly should not be so. The Bible tells us to rejoice always, pray continually, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. But how could we live in such a way when our daily life appears so routine and tedious? I believe that today's passage shows us how. We can rejoice always and give thanks in all circumstances when we are firmly established and rooted in love and have the power to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ and to know this love that surpasses knowledge. If we are genuinely in love with Christ every day, our daily lives will be filled with thrill and excitement. We should feel the love of Christ in a fresh manner as if we were forever in the first love with the Lord. That must be why the Lord rebuked the church in Ephesus for forsaking the first love. Yet I hold this against you, you have forsaken the love you had at first. Consider how far you have fallen. Repent and do the things you did at first, Revelation 2:4-5. Apostle Paul says, "For this reason, I kneel before the Father, 15 from whom every family in heaven and on earth derives its name. I pray that out of his glorious riches, he may strengthen you with power through his Spirit in your inner being, so that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith." He earnestly prayed that we may have a genuine understanding of the profundity of the love of Christ, for he was certain that it would transform our daily life. I believe that is the genuine wish of the Lord for us too. This is why we Christians should not be content with superficial knowledge of the gospel. The deeper and higher we know about the love of Christ, the more joyful and thankful our daily life will become. Are you having such a joyful and thankful life every day?